to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing an energy read for Litha. So for the twin flame, so the divine masculine and the divine feminine, and like what the energies, how the energies are affecting each one of us. So let's get into it. Oh, and if you guys want a private reading, check in the description box below. So okay, let's really get into it now. So we're starting with the divine feminine. So what these energies will bring, we pulled Freya and Sulis. So Sulis, bodies of water, Freya. So there is going to be this, the Litha is going to be bringing us like a lot of feelings of movement. We're going to be feeling like moving and like doing things, and we're going to feel like, you know, doing things differently. Like here with this bold card, like we want to do, you know, yeah, we want to take some risks. We want to make some changes in our life, and we want to cut out things that aren't, you know, vibrating on that wavelength with us. If we feel like, you know, we are feelers, like us divine feminine. So like you, whenever we are feeling like there's something that's not vibing with us, or if there is something that we want to change, we are going to be emboldened to make those changes because of these energies. These energies are pushing us to, you know, feel more and do more. So what to focus on, we pulled, ooh, that's a mess. We pulled Aim and Callie, Leap of Faith and Endings and Beginnings. Like, what am I doing right now? Okay, so Leap of Faith. What we need to focus on is ourself. Self-betterment and dream actualization. Like, if there's anything that us divine feminines have been putting off, or like if we're not happy in a situation, like that's what we need to be focusing on, because our dreams are easily manifested during this time. It's like it's a fire energy. It's a lot of like fire. I don't know how else to explain that. It's just a lot of movement. You're gonna want to move, and you're gonna want to make changes, like I had said earlier. So that's what I'm saying. Like, and we pulled the card Endings and Beginnings because in order to usher in the new, the old must be let go of in order to, you know, get what you have dreamt of, get what you've been wanting. So yeah, that's what we need to focus on. Like, whatever it is that we know that is not of our highest good, or we know that is not working for us, or thought forms, or, you know, personality traits, whatever, what have you. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's time now to really focus on that. Think about what it is that we want to let go of and usher in, and act on that. Take that leap of faith. And so then, what to let go of, we pulled Guinevere, True Love, and Diana, Focused Intention. So what we need to let go of are feelings of not being enough, feelings of not doing enough, feelings of inadequacy, feeling like, you know, we're not awesome when we are, you know what I'm saying? And not focusing, like I said, we need to focus on ourselves. We need to stop not focusing on ourselves. We need to stop focusing on others so that we can evolve, so that we can change, so that we can get to exactly it, what it is that we want. And if there are any like relationships or situationships that, you know, are just not, they've just played themselves out, and you see that they're not working for you, you gotta cut it out. That's something to, that's definitely something to let go of. Like, we need to focus on really loving ourselves. You know what I'm, like I just said earlier, we need to focus on loving ourselves. We need to focus on attracting what it is that we really want. And yeah, that's basically the energies for the Divine Feminines for Litha. I'll be back with the Divine Masculines. Okay, so for the Divine Masculines, what the Litha energies will be bringing for them, we pulled a leap of faith, which is what we got for the Divine Feminines, but not in the same spot. But yeah, we pulled leap of faith and Divine Passion. So these energies are going to be propelling the Divine Masculine to do what it is that has been on their minds, has been in the back of their minds, things that they've been putting off, or, you know, stuff that they've been putting off, or things that they felt like they didn't need to do right now, but they actually, like, needed to do. They're going to be acting upon that. So whether it be a love interest, or, you know, a creative endeavor, a job, or whatever, the Divine Masculines are going to be feeling the urge to pursue all of that. So what to focus on? We pulled Aracure Blossoming and Ma'at Furnace. So the Divine Masculines need to focus on their self-growth, their personal growth, and they need to focus on balancing out their karma, like finishing up with whatever karma that it is that they have had or whatever. Because now it's time to let these things that have been holding them back go. And so that's why these energies with the leap of faith and the Divine Passion, that's why it's here, because it's like, okay, like, are you done playing? Because there's real energy here. Like, there's real manifestation energy here. Like, are you ready? Like, are you done? You know what I'm saying? So you need to focus on your growth. Yes, like it says, have patience with yourself and the process. Do not give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. I know that, you know, sometimes karma is not easy to balance out. You know what I'm saying? But once it's done, once that cycle is complete, bro, you'll see everything. You will see everything. You know what I'm saying? Everything that you've been missing before, like, you'll be like, oh, wow, that's been front of me like this whole time. So yeah, just focus on you. Like I said, even with the feminines, focus on you, focus on your growth, and focus on, you know, balancing that shit out. And then for what to let go of, we pulled Isis past life and then Ishtar boundaries. So there is for the masculines, there's some type of issue with, like, their past, either past life or people from their past or both, and boundaries. Like, there are people that are infringing upon the masculine's energy and boundaries, and this is part of a past life thing as well. Some Divine Masculines do not have healthy boundaries with others, and that's, I feel like that's part of the karma that is being balanced right now. But yeah, past life things, like, let go of those things from the past. Let go of old thought forms. Let go of, you know, people that are bringing your energy down. Let that go. Let go of those situations, because that is infringing upon your own energy, your own growth, and your own karma, because energy is contagious. And so that's why it's important to have and set healthy boundaries, so that you can, you know, have your own, you can decipher what is yours and what is not. What thought forms are yours, what thought forms are not. You know what I'm saying? Like, Just let it go. Just let all of that go. So that you can see, like I said, that all the these blessings, all everything, focus. You can focus exactly on what it is that you want. Just like with the feminists, you can the feminists are focusing on what it is that they want. The divine masculines have to do the same. And they my space got used up a little bit, so I had to delete some things. But so they definitely need to focus on, you know, themselves, balancing out their karma, all these boundaries that they haven't had with others, that needs to be in place now, like now, because not having healthy boundaries is infringing upon their growth. The masculines, I'm speaking to you, is infringing upon your growth. What am I talking about there? Like, this is just a divine feminine reading. No, divine masculines, I hope you're watching this too, because this is very important information. So yeah, just focus on you, focus on balancing, and you'll be okay. And yeah, that's what these energies for Litha has brought us, is bringing us. And yeah, I love you guys, and I'll talk to y'all later.